They give me you. Everything else. Can't wait. Matter of fact, when you, if I got him, everything else will work. Well, the Bible says, and I read it, I'm going to read it, I think some of y'all read it too, that all things work together for good. For those who love the Lord. Those who are called according to his purpose. So it don't matter what it is. If I got him, it's going to work out. Come on, talk to me. Everything else can work. Hallelujah. Thank you. You was quiet. Lord, just work through them and just bless us. They got some very anointed voices. And those in that choir, those kids can sing. Amen. They don't even, well, they might be introduced to some stuff, but they don't have to worry about all that stuff like we worry about. Just a Christian grab that mic, like, okay. Have a care in the world, amen. If I mess up, so what? If you're looking at me funny, so what? I'm going to go ahead and read it, amen. You know what? We ought to have that kind of attitude, amen. Because what? What's going to be, going to be. Who's going to talk about you, going to talk about it. Who's not going to like you, not going to like you. Amen. But I'm glad that the Lord loves me, amen. I said the Lord loved me, so he would give me favor with some folk, amen, because I realize I'm not crazy enough to know that everybody don't love me. Actually, I'm glad. You know why? It made me pray that much harder. You're tight, but you're right. You know what? When I know you don't like me and I can pray for you, that means I've grown a little more in the Lord. That's all it means. That's all it means. You read in the book, amen, Jesus always walked alone. Them sad folks, all them Sadducees, he always walked among them, knowing how they felt. He still loved. That's why he said, any man won't come after me. Let him deny himself. See, self, I had you cutting up. Self will have you saying ugly stuff that you can't take back. That's why he said, no. He said, you won't come after me. He said, you got to get out of the way. And that's what it was. Take up your cross. Take up what you think you know. Take up who you think you are. Just follow me. The reason why he said follow me, because you don't know where you're going. Without me, you get lost. Amen. Thank God. Jesus. I am so honored to be in your presence today. I said, I am so honored to be in your presence. I could have been dead, sleeping in my grave. Amen. And I don't take life for granted. God, let me see another day. I am grateful. And I am careful. I don't want to hurt nobody. I don't want to be ugly with nobody. Amen. I want to tell you the truth and love everybody. Because what? God gave me one more chance. Amen. And I'll tell you something else. I know where my help comes from. Amen. My help comes from the Lord, which made the heavens and the earth and the grass that grew on and run. Amen. The rain that run, the rain that rained yesterday, the sun that shined is his world. He just allowed me to be a part of it. Amen. So be careful of how you act this day. You may not see tomorrow.
That's right.
Amen. Oh, Lord. Something I found out. People, person is always up in the air. He's never satisfied by nothing. He just, they need some peace. All right. Which surpasses their understanding. Amen. When you're at peace, you don't have a kick. You just relaxing in the Lord. And stuff don't even bother. Because what? You are surrounded, you are saturated in the peace of God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. That's the word. Philippians 4. Our White House needs some peace. But guess what? Our house needs some peace. Let me tell you something else. You can't pray for that house unless your house is peaceful. Come on, talk to me. Amen. The Bible says the prayers of the righteous avail as much. Amen. But I come to the conclusion that I'm going to leave. But I want to live peacefully. As I approach and get closer to my golden years, if I live to see them, I don't want to be frustrated. I don't want to be an old frustrated man. Come on, talk to me. Amen. We ought to be peaceful years. You can sit on the couch, grab back if you want to, get up if you want to, or sit there. But be peaceful while you're sitting there. Grandma and them had it right. Ain't nothing worse than a young is old. I'm not going to say it. Amen. But it's true. Some words people don't like what you say. But they'll say anything they want. Amen. If you want to curve them out, okay. That's all right. That's all right. Philippians 4. Mm-hmm. Therefore. Now see that? Therefore is a continuation, and you back up, you'll see what it's there for. Therefore, my brethren, dearly beloved, and long for my joy and crown. Paul loved these people. So stand in the Lord, my dearly beloved. I beseech, let me see, Euodias, and beseech sit tonight, amen. That's close enough. That they be of the same mind in the Lord. That's the message. And I entreat thee also, true yoke fellowman, yoke fellow, help those women which labor with me in the gospel, with Clement, also with other my fellow laborers whose name are in the book of life. That covers everybody. Verse 4 says, rejoice in the Lord always. And again, I say rejoice. Let your moderation, which means self-control, be known to all men. The Lord is at hand. When you're around people, Lord ought to have control of your life. And people will know that the Lord is at hand. Why? Because the way you act, the way you talk, the way you walk, the way you live, the Lord is at hand. Be careful for nothing. Don't worry. But in everything, prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, that your request be made known to the Lord, to God. Verse 7. All these things come before, verse 7. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. I want to throw this one in here. John 14:27 said, peace
I leave with you my peace. I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, giveth I unto you. Let not your hearts be troubled. Neither let it be afraid. God, we pray now that you will bless your word. Bring further clarity to your word. Bring edification to your people. And then God, your name will be glorified. Use us now to preach your word to your people. God will be careful to give you the praise. In Jesus' name. Every heart said, amen.
Amen.
Say in Jesus' name, go to your seat.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name. Hallelujah to the Lamb of God. Anybody know he's worthy?
Yes.
I said, anybody know he's worthy?
Yes.
Amen. He knows it. Do you know why he rose from the dead? He walks with me. Do you know why he rose from the dead? He talks with me. And a dead man can't talk. I said, a dead man can't pull up and say, what you talking about this Sunday morning? If he hadn't stayed in the grave, he's not dead.
Amen.
Amen.
Stay woke a little while longer.
Amen.
Stand up my back. All right. Amen.
So I got the amen back here.
Right.
I got the amens up here. I got the amens here. Precept shoes. We got it going on. What are you for your message from the Lord? Experiencing the peace of God. Peace can be all around us. Peace is there for us. But we must get in position in our minds, in our hearts, to experience this peace. Amen. The Bible teaches us that we don't let the sun go down on our wrath. And what it means is, amen, when mama taught me that prayer, now lay me down to sleep. She was in a peaceful state of mind. Do I have a witness here? She had had a talk with God, and God had put her at peace. And when God put her at peace, then she could teach that peaceful prayer to her children. Now lay me down to sleep. Pray the Lord my soul to keep. She would say, if I die before I wake, pray the Lord my soul to take. Other words, amen, if I die in my sleep, I'm going in the presence of the Lord. If my children die in their sleep, they're going in the presence of the Lord. Because what? We were very young at that time. But I remember that prayer. Amen. I pray it now. I prayed it then, and I'm going to pray it now. Amen. Because what I want the Lord to watch over me while I slumber and sleep. I want the Lord to wake me up to see another day. Amen. Because the enemy will sometimes try to choke you in your sleep. Spirit in the peace of God. Then the subtitle would be living at peace.
All
right. I found out, amen, you can be saved but not peaceful.
All right.
Now we have disturbing moments. We have moments that we be up in the air.
Well,
amen. But God ought to be able to have enough control in our lives to sever us back down.
Amen.
Am I right?
Amen.
When you get some news and the news, amen, it's just come unexpected.
Yeah.
That'll have you all up in the air.
Yeah.
But God will have enough control in your life.
Yeah.
Amen. To bring you back down where he can talk to you. Where he can put you at ease and let you know that everything is going to be all right.
Yeah.
God, we serve. Amen. That's why the word says we've been there and do it for a night. But God comes in the morning. It's because we got a God of peace.
Yeah.
I feel like preaching in here.